So hello everyone, welcome to our channel Physics 4AP. And last episode we were discussing about the nomenclature that is giving name to the organic compounds. So today let's see a little bit more examples about the carbon compounds over here. And let's see, here we have a compound like CH2 bond CH2 bond OH bond OH. So here we have a carbonic compound, that is CH2 bond CH2, so OH. So that means we have two functional groups over here, that is alcohol OH connected with two branches of a carbon compounds here. So the first thing is that first we have to give the numbers here. So number can be given in any way, as there are equal functional groups, so 1 and 2. So 2 are given, so 2 function, the number of carbons are 2. So if the number of carbons are 2, then we call it as eth. Then the bonds, the number of bonds which are present here. So the number of bonds between the carbon atoms are the single bond, so we write it as A and N. And if you see here, we have a function group of alcohol, that is OH. So the given compound is not a hydrocarbon, so it has an alcoholic group as OH. So that alcohol is present in the first position and as well as in the second position also. So we have to write as in the suffix part, that is hyphen. In the first position we have alcohol, so 1, comma. In second position we have another alcohol, that is 2, hyphen. And as there are two alcohols, so same as in previous episode, for 2 chlorides how we have written as for di. Here also we have write as for 2 alcohols, we write it as di. And the suffix for the alcohol is ol. So the overall compound name is ethane 1,2-diol. So this is the name of the organic compound which is given over here. So let's have a little bit bigger one, the complex one. Now let's see. So CH3 bond C, double bond O, bond CH2, CH3. So here we have a compound which is having a double bond O, so that is which has a ketone group. So this type of a functional group which we have is said to be called as a ketone. As if you see in the paper which I have given that in the previous episode. So here we have C double bond O, which is called the ketone group over here. So better once revise the paper over here, and let's see the name of the compound what we get here. So first what we have to do is we have to give the numbering system over here. So the numbering system, it can be start from 1, 2, 3, 4, and from this side 1, 2, 3, 4. So if you see here 1, 2, 3, 4. In other ways, 1, 2, 3, 4. So as we have a functional group which is starting from second position at one side and another side we have third position. So which one we need to take? Whether the first one or the down one? Yes, the first one, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, we need to take. So the down one should not be considered as it takes longer here. So as we have four carbons we write it as but. And what about the bonds present here? Are they single bonds or double bonds? See here, for each and every carbons we have single bond. But don't get confused that here we have a double bond with oxygen. It is not with the carbon. It is with the oxygen. So we should not consider that as a double bond like alkane and alkene. So we write it as but. So all the carbons are having a single bond with each other. So we write it as ane. And in the second position, we have a ketone group. So we can write it as 2 hyphen. So the suffix for the ketone group is written as one. butane to ओन, और इट कैन बी रिटन एज टू ब्यूटानोन. इज इट क्लियर? नाउ वॉट हैपन्स इफ इट द चेन सिस्टम इज बीन एक्सटेंडेड. सो इफ इट इज बीन एक्सटेंडेड द प्रॉपर्टीज गेट्स चेंजेड. CH2 bond CH2 bond CH2 bond OH. CH2 bond OH. Now here we have a carbon compound. So first we need to start giving the numbering. So first where we need to start giving the numbering. So whether it should be start from first or whether it should be start from last. So as there are two functional group, one is the ketone group and another one is the alcohol group over here. So when you see the priority series, in the priority series over here, as if you see in this priority series, so here when compared to ketones and alcohols, ketone is the first priority when compared to the alcohols. So it has greater priority. So the priority what we have to give is the first priority we have to give it for the ketone, then we have to give it for the alcohol which is present over here. So let's start giving the numbering from here, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So we have 6 carbons over here. So the first thing we need to do is first we have to write the root word. So 6 carbons, so we write it as hex. And all are having the single bonds, so we write it as N. And in the second position we have a ketone group, the ketone functional group. So the ketone function group we write it as the suffix as 2-one. Is it completed till now? No. Why? Because here we have a function group. As here we have a function group which is the alcohol, that comes under the prefix. That is, as it is in the sixth position, so we write it as 6-hydroxy-hexane-2-one. So the name of the compound which is given is 6-hydroxy-hexane-2-one. So this is the name of the carbon compound. And let's see another example with more chain systems. Let us take an example with the more chain systems. So CH3, CH2, 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 CH3 bond, CH2, CH2, CH2. CH3. So here we have a longest chain system of a carbon. CH2, CH3. So this is a longest chain system of a carbon compound. So in this, how we have to give the name and how we have to take the numbering system out here. So if we say we have to start counting it over here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So in this chain system, we are getting 8 carbons over here. So now let us take this chain system. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That means we are having 9 carbons in this chain system. Let us take this chain system. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 carbons we are having. So which chain system would we should like to be chosen over here? As if you see here, 1 2 3, the first chain system we have 8 carbons, and over here the corner chain system we have also 8 carbons, and this corner system we have 9 carbons over here. So according to the norm IUPAC system, we have to take the longest chain system over here. So the longest chain system is this, which is consisting of 9 carbons over here. So we have to take the chain system which is having the longest part, that is 1. So let us give the number for that. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So completely totally 9 carbons we have over here. Now what about the carbons which are present on this part over here? So that will be considered as the functional group. So that will be considered as the functional group over here. Functional group. So now let us write the name of this compound. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9 carbons. So we write it as non, that is 9 carbons. So the number of bonds which are present, the bonds, the type of bonds here we have all are the single bonds. So we write it as an. And here all are having the carbon hydrocarbons. So we write it as E. Non, that is for 9 carbons. An, that is for the single bonds. And E is represent for the hydrocarbons. Now, what about the position of this over here? The functional group, that is, as it is present in the 5th position. If you take on this side also, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So both are in the same place. So here we have in the fifth position, we have a functional group which is having it 1, 2, 3, 3 carbons. So 3 carbons means actually we call it as propane. But when it undergoes into the functional group, then it is called as propyl. It is called as propyl. So we can write it as 5 propyl nonane. So name seems to be different over here. So the name of the hydrocarbon which is given is 5 propyl nonane. So nonane is for the 9 carbons, the compound which is present here, and 5 propyl is that the in the 5th position we have a propyl function group over here. So the chain system that what we have to take is which is having the longest chain system of a carbon, that chain system should be considered for writing the nomenclature, for writing the name of an organic compound. Is it clear now? Now let's take another example. So let's take another example over here. So CH2, double bond C, double bond C, bond Cl, bond CH, bond Cl, bond CH2, bond CH2, bond CH, bond CH2. Here OH and here OH. So this is a big carbon chain organic compound, and let's start giving the number. So where should we start giving the number? So here we have a function group of alcohol, OH, and here we have another function group, that is chlorine, that is the halogens, and here we have a double bond. So remember that when compared to the triple bond and double bond, the functional groups what we have, the alcohol, the aldehyde or carboxylic acid, whatever it may be, so those are considered as the main priority when compared to the triple bond and the double bond over here. That means for giving the numbers, these functional groups should be considered as the first priority. So here as we have a functional group of alcohol, that is OH, and here we have a double bond, so we should start giving the numbers that should be coming from over here, that is from the right side. So here we have to give the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So total 8 carbons are present. So as we have a double bond over here, we should not give the numbering from here. Why? Because here we have a function group. So we should start writing the number from here. But if there are present, if there are no function groups over here, but only if there are present of double bonds and single bonds and triple bonds, then we should consider the first priority for the triple bond, then for the double bond. But when the functional groups are present, the first priority should be given to the functional groups. And among those functional groups, there is a priority series which I have given you in the paper, that which is seen in the previous video. So here, the first thing is which we have given the numbers. And the second thing is we have to write the root word. So root word, as we have 8 carbons. So 8 carbons, so we write it as oct. So 8 carbons we have as oct, O-C-T, oct, oct. And what about the bonds present here? So the bonds are, here we have a double bond, which is present in the 6th position and in the 7th position over here. So what we have to write is here, oct hyphen 6, 7, that is in the 6th position and 7th position we have a double bond. Both are the same double bond, so we write it as 6, 7. So two double bonds are there, so we write it as di. And the double bonds which we have here, we write it as ene, diene. And in the first and the second position, so in the first and the second position we have a alcohol group, so that comes under the suffix, so 1, 2. So 1, 2 diol. So 1, 2 diol, which is the name for the chain system which is present over here. So oct 6, 7 diene, 1, 2 diol. Now what about the functional groups which are present? We have a functional groups at 5th position we have a chlorine and 6th position we have another chlorine. So what we can write is 5, 6 hyphen, and as there are two chlorines, so two are same, so we write it as di chloro. So the overall name which we give, which we have for the given compound, is writing in single statement. So 5, 6 dichloro oct, 6, 7 diene hyphen, 1, 2 diol. So this is the complete name of the compound. So you can create your own carbon, and you can create your own carbon and give your own name for the organic compounds which is present over here. So let's take another example of giving the nomenclatures. So let's take another example. So in next episode we'll be having the names. Based upon the names, we'll be have to draw the structures. Now in this episode we will give the structures and we have to write the names, and in the next video the name will be given, then we have to write the structures over here. So let us see CH3 bond CH, bond CH3, bond CH2, bond CH2, bond C, bond CH3. So here we have a carbon compound, and let's see the numbers, where does it starts from. So if you see from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So here we have 6 number of carbons, and in the other side we have, you can write it as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That means in these two ways we can write the numbers for that chain system, and which number system which we have to follow, the number whether the up one or down one. So if you see here, in the second position we have CH3, and in the fifth position we have two functional groups over here. Is it clear? The fifth position we have two functional groups over here. Now when you count the numbers, that is in second position we have one function group, plus in fifth we have another function group, that is 5 plus 5. Total how much we are going to get here? 12. And is it getting here at this, the in the first number rule, second position we have function group CH3. I wrote its position. And in the fifth position there are two function groups over here. So 5 plus 5, that is one for the CH3 and another one for the CH3. When you count it, you got it as 12. Now count the number system for the down one. The down one. Second position we have CH3, that is second position for CH3 and another second position for CH3. And we have a number system which is present at the fifth, that is CH3 is present in the fifth position. So total 5 plus 2, 7, 7 plus 2, 9. Now which is the lower one, lower value? 9 is the lower. That means we have to follow the number system from right to left. So we should not take from left to right, while as the number system is taken as 12 over here. So we should not consider the number system for the upper part. That is, now so let's write the name of the carbon compound over here. So as we have 6 carbons, so we can write it as hex, and all the carbons are having a single bond, so we can write it as an. And here we have a hydrocarbons, all are the hydrocarbons, so we write it as E. So hexane is the name of this chain system. Now coming to the function groups. So when we coming to the function groups, we have CH3, here we have CH3, and here we have CH3. So all are present in the, here we have 2 and here we have 5, all are the CH3. So what we can write is, let's start writing from on this side. So 2, all are the same function group, so 2, 2, and here 5. So 2, 2, 5 hyphen. So all are CH3. So if we, there are 3, what we have to write? As I told before, if there are 2, we have to write as di. If there are 3, we have to write it as tri. So as there are 3 same functional groups, we have to write it as tri. And the functional group which we have is methyl. So the overall name which we get here is 2, 2, 5 trimethyl hexane. So this is the name of the compound which we have over here. Is it clear? Now let's take another example. So we can create a number of carbon compounds, our own carbon compounds, if you get a good idea of the nomenclature. So you can create your own number of carbon compounds over here. So let's take an example of COOH, CH2, C, here we have a chlorine, and here also we have a chlorine bond, C, here we have OH, H bond, C, H, O. So where we should start giving the number system? So whether it should be start from here or it should start from here. So here we have COH, which is the carboxylic acid, and here we have function group of alcohol, and here we have function group of aldehyde. The first priority should be given for the carboxylic acid. So the numbering system should start from here. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So as there are number of 5 carbons, so we write it as bent, and all the carbons bonds which are present here are the single bonds, so we write it as ane. And here we have a functional group of COOH, which is carboxylic acid, so we write it as oic acid. So or one oic acid we can write it, or one we can represent it or not. That's one doesn't mention a specified number, so we write it as oic acid. Now coming to the functional groups over here, so in functional groups we have third position we have chlorine, fourth position we have alcohol, and fifth position we have aldehyde. So what we can write is, at third position we have chlorine over here, that is 3, 3. So we can write it as 3, 3 hyphen dichloro. Is it clear? Now coming to the fourth position, 4 hydroxy, and fifth position we have a aldehyde, so we can write it as 5-formyl. So the name is a little bit bigger one, so it cannot be fit on the screen. So we can write it as 3, 3 dichloro, 4-hydroxy, 5-formyl pentanoic acid. So this is how we can create our own carbon compounds and create a new name. But remember one thing, that for each and every carbon there should exist of 4 carbons. So 4 carbons should be present between them, then you can create your own carbon compound. So with the help of the table which I have given to you, so with the help of that you can create your own carbon compounds over here. So let's go for the last example. So we have one more thing, that is CH bond CH bond CH2 bond CH2 Br and Br. So we have this kind of thing which is till now we have done with an open chain system. So this is another example which is of a closed chain. So closed chain or cyclic hydrocarbon over here. So if we have this kind of a chain system, then the number system where we have to start. The first thing is, these are the functional groups over here. Now the number system should start from where the functional group is present. So 1. Next, the second position, the second number should not go for CH2. Why? Because on the next chain system we have another bromine which is the functional group. So we have to give the number over there. Now complete the chain system. So 1, 2, 3 and 4. So total 4 carbons. So 4 carbons we write it as bute, and all the carbons are having a single bond. So we ane, and all these are the hydrocarbons, so we can write it as E. So butane. And in first position and second position we have a bromine over here. So we can write it as 1, 2 dibromo. But the very thing is, if you write 1, 2 dibromo, so what does it happen is, it becomes the structure like this. So here Br and here Br. That means if you give 1, 2 dibromobutane in this manner the name, then it goes, that IUPAC name goes for this organic compound, that is CH2Br, CH2Br, CH2 and CH3. So as this organic compound and the organic compound which are given here, so both are different. So why? Because this is an open chain system. So this is an open chain system, and the given which is given here is a closed chain system. So what we have to write is 1, 2 dibromo. We have to add a name which is called as cyclobutane. Now when we add the word cyclo, that means it represents a closed chain hydrocarbon. So the name of this hydrocarbon which we get here is 1, 2 dibromo. cyclobutane. But if you go for this, the answer will be 1,2 dibromobutane. Cyclo doesn't gets add to this. Is it clear with that? Till now what we have discussed? So we have discussed about the nomenclature of a carbon compounds, and today we have discussed about that in this video, giving the structure, how to write the name of a given carbon compound. And in the next episode, you will be having the name of a carbon compound. With the help of the name of the carbon compound, how to draw the structures over here. It's just quite simple that how we do for this. First, what we do is we write the root word for this carbon chain, and we see the bonds, and we see whether there is any suffix and prefix, we write it. In the same way also, first we will see the root word, and we write the root word, the number of carbons over here. We see the bonds, and we see there is any suffix or prefix, we just come and flip it on over here. So it's very easy, and don't get confused. So chemistry, organic chemistry, is the very easiest subject when compared to others. The only thing is you need to concentrate, and you need to practice on this nomenclature, IUPAC system. So right now, thank you for watching the video, and regarding any doubts, you can give a comment, give a thumbs up, and subscribe the video. You can give a like and give your valuable comment. Thank you, everyone.